Rotary Club in the
universe.
So with that, we will do the flag salute. No, we're going to do prayer first. Rick?
Let's pray on prayer. Heavenly Father, as we enter into the holiday season to honor your only begotten Son, we give praise to you. We give thanks to you for having our longtime member, John Mattern, back and joining us this afternoon. We hope you give us strength to help us to benefit our community by doing good deeds to those that are less fortunate than ourselves and bringing goodwill to those that we can certainly help to benefit for a better life. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Flag salute.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Now, for those that don't have it memorized, we like to think everybody does. It is over here on this blue thing. Now, if you're an existing Rotarian, if I see you looking over here, that's not good. That might cost you a dollar later. But for anybody else, it's the four-way test.
Is it the truth? Is it fair to all concerned? Will it build goodwill and better friendships? Will it be beneficial to all concerned?
Now with that, everybody have a seat. Our song today is going to be provided by...
So we're going to stay standing.
Oh, we're going to stay standing.
Can I get Sarah Hall up here, please? Sarah, come on. Sarah's a senior at Cedar Valley High School, and I'm enlisting her to help us sing our song. Oh, here's Sarah. All right, so we're going to sing Jingle Bells, and we're going to have Sarah start us on. Rudolph, that was me. You're right. Rudolph.
He's still mine though.
other guests? Okay, on to matters of business. At the end of the meeting, I need to have the board meet to talk about a few more new members. We are approaching about 95 members now in the club. We have four more that will be being added here soon. And we seem to have some more interest. So if you are still watching and seeing people that might be great members of our club, we'll try and keep that process going. So around the room, who's got the mic? Okay, I'll try and make it so it's not too far off. Curtis, right? Why don't you start us off up front here?
All right, tomorrow is Dictionaries for Third Graders. We are meeting at the Trail Road office at 8 a.m. to install the book plates. And then at 9 a.m. we'll go out and distribute the dictionaries to each school. I have Christine Kilcup and Chris Johnson and Doug Wood signed up for helping out tomorrow morning to install the book plates. Anybody else want to help out?
I'll be there.
Okay. See you there. Trail Road School District Office, 8 a.m. I have Avery for Big Lake.
Sure.
Okay. Chris Johnson and Keith Wagner for Central. Okay, please coordinate with each other for getting the dictionaries distributed. Rod Hall for Clear Lake. Is Rod here? Okay. Concrete, Mark Venn, delivery on 12-7. Evergreen, Christine Kilcup and Holy Kelly. And Lemon, Mark Nielsen, and Rick Tesserick the following week, though. And Mary Purcell, Doug Wood. And Samish, myself. So if anybody else wants to help distribute to a particular school, let me know. Yeah.
If
Rod
doesn't make it, I can take
his.
Okay.
I'll be here.
Great, thank you.
So if you're a fairly new member of our Rotary Club and you haven't done dictionaries in the past, whether you can help put the nameplates on or not, if you would like to participate, you should jump in one of the cars when we take them to the school.
That's a lot of fun. It's a blast.
So next up, Bill McCann.
We're coming up on crystal ball time again, so if you're on the committee or if you're not on the committee and would like to submit questions for next year's test, get them to me or John Ward or any other member of the committee. John likes 90% of all the questions and they're always excellent, but we're looking for anything from anybody in any category you want to think of, national, international, local, whatever. We'll probably have the presentation in February. That's kind of what we usually do, and so we'll scoring last year's test by the end of the year, and then we'll be working on the new one. So if anybody has questions to submit, do so, please.
And Teach, I think you're right by it.
Yeah, news from the International Committee. Number one, the buying process of equipment for the clinic in Nueva Armenia, Honduras has started, so I'm real encouraged about that. Number two is we're switching villages to a village called Carasolita for the adopt the school and adopt the student. The club per se is adopting a school to provide the uniforms, packs, supplies for the kids every February when they start school after the coffee season. And the adopt the student is for keeping a student in school. Normally they quote graduate unquote in sixth grade from primary school and the middle school. Not too many know, so we're trying to keep those students in school for another 3 years. So I'm looking for people to sponsor a student, $140 a year for a 3-year commitment. You know, about 50-50 on whether they'll stay in school for 3 more years before the difference in coming out with a ninth grade or a sixth grade education is day and night. And the good thing about the new village is it's easy walking distance to the middle school, which is a problem with these real distances. enrichment villages out away from middle schools. So anyone interested in sponsoring a student from middle school, please talk to me after the meeting. Thank you.
Could we get somebody through a year of school for $140 in Washington State?
The interesting thing on this system is the government will pay for the teacher, the school building and everything, the village has to keep up, the uniforms and packs and all the villagers have to buy for their kids. And most of these folks in the villages are dirt, corn, bean farmers who go to coffee season in 3 or 4 months a year. They earn all their cash for the whole year, but they really don't have that money for the kids to be able to get uniforms or a backpack. So it's a real blessing in their lives to get these things and have all the kids equipped for school in these little schools. And I'll show you pictures when I get back from my January trip to Honduras.
So, T, how many kids are we trying to get sponsorship for right now?
We need 8 total in this village. The good thing is I get to bring back pictures and read them. If we go over that, then we have other villages that we help out with, and I'll go out and try to meet those students to go bring you pictures home.
Okay. Jackie, next one.
Just wanted to remind everybody that the Christmas party is Saturday night at 6 o'clock at John and Katie Janicki's. Don't forget to bring something for the food bank, either cash or food. And we'll be doing a collection there. And then Rick?
Becky?
Yes.
What time do you want help at the storage unit tomorrow?
I'm not sure yet.
Okay.
We'll talk. We'll let you know. We have some things to discuss about that. But in that regard, it's been a very busy weekend for organizations. We're having some trouble getting a few people to assist in parking the vehicles up at John's house. The school's got activities with Janicki's and these types of things. So at this point, we do not have people to park cars. So if we can't coordinate that, Carrie is working hard on that with some students and things. So it might be dropping off and parking your own vehicle on Saturday. So be advised, maybe dress for that too. So,
Travis, next.
Well, if you've noticed, there's some very beautiful poinsettias and wreaths at the back of the room here. The Boy Scouts delivered them today. So for those of you that placed an order, we'll be back there with the scouts after the meeting and settle up with you if you have to pay, and then deliver your poinsettias and wreaths. So thank you very much.
Do you have extras on top of the orders or just the orders?
Just the orders.
Okay.
That's good for next year, though. That's
all right. All right, Sandra, up front here.
So you guys, last year during the crystal ball test, if you answered the question, will Sandra Whiten be married by the end of 2017 with a no, you're going to have to pay a dollar later, because I'm getting married on December 15th. So I'm going to pay it.
Great
catch.
I already did that. Are there any other
announcements? Does he not watch YouTube?
He watched again. We started meeting you. We're coming up on it. And I'm trying to reduce the stress on Rick again. So we're after the silent auction items. He's going to have the sheets here next week. And we would like to have people start bringing those in, the silent auction items. You will be severely punished if you don't bring one in as far as your fines, and maybe in an increasing amount. But if you do bring them in, you probably get immunity. And I talked to the January team. Adrian has agreed to that we can hand out immunity for January too. So we urge you to get your silent auction items in December.
Well, with everything else going on this weekend, don't forget we have a parade downtown and a tree lighting at 5 o'clock. There are kids that are going to be able to ride ponies and in the trains and get their faces painted before the parade. And we will have music from some of the high school students there at the parade, right, kids? Yes. They often win awards for that sort of thing, you know. But don't forget the lights. You've got to be lit up. That's important. I always tell the judges that's the most important thing is music comes after lights. So.
So last night we did a tasting at Maxdale's for the auction food a little earlier this year than we normally have been. And it went very well, you know, as expected. All of it was great. We settled on a salmon dish and a dish with prime rib. Can't go wrong with prime rib for Maxdale's. So everything is going to be great this year. And they did a great job once again with the tasting. And the chef was you know, very helpful at asking all of our questions. I like to ask questions. I'm an engineer, so. But it went very well, so I hope everybody's happy with our choices. But it was actually pretty easy to make the choice, so it was also good. So, anything else?
That's it. Good. So, for new members that are part of the club, you need to come and talk to me about what committees you might like to be on. But if you want to be on the committee that has to do tasting at Maxdale's, that's not a bad committee to be on. To sit there for 2 or 3 hours and you have to just keep putting more food in front of you and say, what do you think of this? And then, you know, just walk away and it's part of the process. So definitely think about that being a committee you want to be on. All right. Any other announcements from the floor that might have gotten missed? Yes, okay.
I just wanted to ask if anybody is interested in working on the bond committee. We have a bond coming up in February that hopefully we can pass and make our wonderful schools even better. We're having a meeting on Monday night at 6 o'clock at the SSB building. That's the school district buildings there on Cook Road, just off Trail Road. We need help on the bond with ideas and so on and so forth. So if you could be there Monday night, we'd greatly appreciate it. Thank you.
Any other announcements from the floor? All right. Do we have a raffle?
We have a raffle.
So just briefly, from a long list of applicants, we've narrowed it down to one person that is willing to be president-elect, and that's Mark Venn. So we need to put his name out there for a couple weeks, and if you know of any dirt on him, you can tell me now. He's not here. Oh, and a couple other things. Team December, I think we're set up for the first couple of weeks. We don't need to meet after this meeting. And for those of you that are taking dictionaries out to the kids, please get a couple pictures on your phone and text them to Avery or someone so we can have those and show them here.
In fact, take pictures whenever you can, even if it's somewhat inappropriate. You know, if we catch Rotarians, like somebody should take a picture of David Brickin today while he's here, because he's got so many wonderful husky, you know, memorabilia things on. Why don't you stand up, Dave? I would keep that in the PowerPoint for a few weeks if we could get a picture of him. But we have activities going on all the time. We're going to be at the Trail Road tomorrow working on the dictionary. We're going to be at schools. We're going to have a Christmas party. We've got bingo coming up in December. All right, so keep a look at that on your calendar. We have a board meeting coming up. There's a lot more activities that we're trying to add and get everybody involved. So, Sergeant Marks. Sandra, take over.
All right. This is going to be quick because
We want this band to play. So first of all, if you're a Cougar and you hoot and holler every time one of the Rotary Students of the Month announces they're going to WSU, I'm going to need $2 for their absolutely crappy performance.
Sandra probably should. Okay.
Can I have some people? Yes.
I can.
And Nick, in all of this, Josh Rinkwe is exempt today from paying because he drove me down to watch the game. And so he doesn't have to pay any fines today. Now, you Huskies unfortunately have to pay $1 as well because you gave up 14 points after we left the game. And that was awful. Raise your hand if you were in your high school band. If you're in high school right now, put your hand back down. Alright, you owe $1. Way to be in your high school band. Raise your hand if you went to band camp. I just wanted to say that. There's no fun associated with band camp. Alright, raise your hand if you played in a band in college. That's another $1. I don't need to make you go broke. Now this is gonna be, you can just if you want to or if you don't want to, but know that I'm paying attention. I don't know if you guys heard or not, but I'm getting married in 15 days. And none of you are invited to the wedding because it's a very small family wedding, so none of you have to buy me a wedding gift. So I think you should dignify the $1 for that. Oh, and I'm fighting myself. Does anybody have the number 33? Because I bought it and then I lost it. If you can find me the number 33, I'll pay you $1. But I'm going to find myself that. Nope, nobody got it? I lost the number 33.
Happy dollar. How are we doing? Happy dollar.
Oh, happy dollars. Is anybody happy besides me in this room?
I'm happy.
You know, I'm really happy. I don't think I've ever seen the Cougars beat the
what's the name of the team?
Here's $10 for that win. And David, when you got into Rotary in 1988, I was the president. And I vowed that I would wear a hat that was endorsed by all the Cougars. And I found that hat, and I'm going to give it back to you.
Happy to be back. Hospital is only a good place to die.
Huh? Welcome back.
We are happy to have you back.
I want to thank everybody that came down to visit me. Rick and Sherry Tesserick, Chuck and Tony Rule, and John Hinton and Doug Wood, all brave Seattle traffic to get down to Swedish to look at me in my deathbed there. So.
We're really glad you're back, John.
So I've got a happy $5, not because everyone just had it, this fire was here.
What about the beer energy?
Oh yeah, that right there. I'm getting it removed after Rotary. Surgically removed. This W. But my happy $5 is for the arts. We've got great music from Cedarwood High School, the band, and we will all month long for December. You guys are great. It's been so fun watching you through the years. And also, I've got the arts are so important. Tomorrow, I will be spending the weekend at McIntyre Hall on the stage in the wings, backstage, as a member of the cast for the Nutcracker, the 28th annual production of the Schedule Academy Dance Nutcracker. McIntyre Hall is just a magical place to be, to watch a performance, to be a part of a performance, and if you get the opportunity to go to see anything there, you need to do it. We're so lucky for the Jack and Shirley McIntyre family for what they've done in our Rotary Club. We were the first Rotary Club that donated $100,000 for this great, great structure. So that really makes me happy. Oh, and then I'm heading. Because she doesn't have to turn her lights on, it's like she's glowing in her office. Glowing.
Who else is happy?
Well, I just want to piggyback on what David said, in that I'm just so proud of our students.
we're just so proud of the accomplishments and continue to work hard because it makes a difference. So happy 20. Thank you.
Here's a happy 20. That's for our Public Works Director, Mark Freiberger, who, if he isn't the best Public Works Director in the state, I don't know who is. So the city, I may have already talked about this, but we got all three of our TIP grants this year for construction. So I'm happy because I can finally answer the question, when is Fruitdale going to be fixed?
Yes.
Next year, this summer. When is State Street going to be fixed? Next year, this summer. So. And we're also getting sidewalks all the way from the corner of Township out to Fruitdale in front of Doc Campbell's project and Janke Industries. So that's all on Mark Freiberger and his staff.
Talk about myself very much, you guys know that. So when I make statements, you know, you gotta take them seriously. Okay, and now Phil Rossman's gonna introduce our band director. Jerry's gonna do that for me.
Good job.
There you go. Just keep the hand up.
So first off, I just want to thank you for allowing us this opportunity to be here. And also, if you notice, it's November 30th. Normally, we do our concerts the 3 weeks in December. The third week in December would have fallen on our first day of Christmas vacation, holiday break, and so we had to just adjust back 1 week. So thank you for allowing us to start 1 day early in November 30th. We are very grateful to have Mr. Henry at the helm leading the charge with our Brothers program. And how many years have you been at the high school now?
That's my 14th year.
14 years. And I cannot wait to stand next to you and we celebrate 25 years, right? So without further ado, please welcome Mr. Brad Henry and our amazing leaders.
Thank you.
All right, we heard a lot of soloists on that one. We were on trombone, Will Hogan Dam. Trumpet, Ryan Pierce. Saxophone, Jalen Branchler. On the piano, Sarah Hall. On the drums, Dylan Russell. Okay, cool. Next, we're going to go with Santa Baby.
Thank you. Ben Jalen on saxophone, and on the trumpet, Aaron Workman Smith.
All right. I already had a couple people make some announcements. I also wanted to say thank you from the band, and not only for having us here this afternoon, because we love coming here and playing every year, we really look forward to it, and but also just the support. Michelle mentioned earlier that we had, many of you know, we were able to purchase new marching band uniforms over the summer and get those here and be using them here this fall, and I think they look great. I think the students like them a lot more than the ones we had for the previous 20-something years. And so anyway, just thank you to all of you who supported. I know the Rotary Club supported us, and also some individuals and businesses here in town, and it was just amazing to see that support come in. Just whether it was $5, $20, or a lot more than that in some cases. We really appreciate it, and the kids are loving it, and they get to feel really proud when they get out there and they're in that uniform. So you'll see us one more time this year, this Saturday at the Christmas Parade, in those with Santa hats this time instead of our normal shakos. So anyway, we'll see you at the parade. This next one is God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen. Thank you.
115, is that what we're looking at?
Correct.
Okay. Let's do, listen. All right, so we're going to do two more, a short one, and then one that's new to us this year, and we're going to save that one for last. But anyway, this is Let Snow, Let Snow, Let Snow. After the parade's over.
Thank you.
we need to wrap up the meeting, but do you have something to say?
Thank you.
Thank you guys for coming and being part of our Rotary meeting today. And we might see, I think the next 2 weeks we have different groups coming from high school, and boy, what a great time of year. So, don't forget the Christmas party. Saturday night, we have moved dictionaries from this Friday to the following Friday. We'll make some announcements to make sure that's ready to fly. Don't forget the poinsettias in the back of the room. Travis, anything you need to say on that? Okay, that's happening back, and then I need the board for a very, very quick, it'll be 1 minute or less meeting up front. So if I could have just a quick executive meeting with the board members that are still here. And with that, listen, it's December starting next month. Let's go. It'll be so much fun. Have a great week.